The following is a solution to number 18, which is the goodness of fit test for a Poisson distribution. This involves like bacteria in the mouth or something. And the lambda, the mean, is 2.8 or 2.80. And we're asked to find the probability that zero occur, whatever it is. I think it's like bacteria colonies or something. Zero. Probability that one occurs, two, three, four, and then greater than or equal to five. So you can use the formula, but I like to use the software. So I'm going to use the TI-84. And if you go to second vars, which is the distributions, we can go to this Poisson PDF. That stands for the probability density function. And then we're just going to type in the mean, which is mu. In this case, it's lambda. They call it lambda for the Poisson. And then the x value is just what I'm trying to find. So this is the probability of zero, given that the mean is 2.8. And that gives us 0.0608. 0.0608. Okay, I'll do that one more time. And then the other ones I'll just copy down. So then the Poisson PDF, 2.8, and then this time I'm going to make it 1. And then we press enter, and then it's 0.1703, let's say. So 0.1703. Okay, so that's what you're going to do, and then you're going to change it to 2, 3, 4. So I'll just go ahead and copy these down. Whenever you do that, for the 2, you should get 0.2384. For the 3, you should get 0.2225. And then for the probability of 4, you should get 0.1557. Now, for greater than or equal to 5, it's 1 minus the things that you just found. So what you could do is you could just add 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 together, these probabilities, and you take 1 minus that, and that'll give you the probability that it's greater than or equal to 5, because we don't have enough time to do probability of 5 plus probability 6, 7, 8, 9, all the way up to infinity. You know, we don't have enough time. So instead, it's quicker if we just take the total, which is 1, minus the probabilities that we don't want, which is 0 through 4. Now, fortunately, there is a function on the calculator that adds it up for you if you want to use it. You don't have to. But it's called the Poisson CDF. CDF stands for the cumulative density function. So it's 1 minus the Poisson CDF. So if we go second distribution, and you may have seen it already, it's the Poisson CDF. Actually, you know what? I'm going to second quit because I forgot to do 1 minus. So 1 minus Poisson CDF. And remember, the mean was 2.8. Now, instead of the x value being, I'm not going to say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to say 4. So the calculator automatically knows that it's 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, the probabilities associated with that. And we paste it in there, and that gives us 0.1523. Okay, so let's write that down. So equals 0.1523. So those are all the probabilities. The second part of this, so part B, it says find the expected value if the sample size n was 100. Now that's kind of nice because the math is super easy. We're just going to take, and I'll just show it for the first one, we take the sample size, which is 100, times each associated probability, and that's going to give you the expected value. So really all you got to do is just move the decimal place over twice to the right, and that's going to give you 6.08 and then 17.03, whenever you multiply, 23.84, 22.25, 15.57, and then greater than or equal to 5 is 15.23. So those are all the expected values. And that's going to lead us to our goodness of fit test. So the observed, that was the chart that was given. So 0, we observed 12 to have 0. We observed 15 to have 1. We observed 29 to have 2, and so on and so forth. So I wrote those down. Now I got to write down the expected. So remember the expected for each of these, 6.08, 17.03, 23.84, 22.25. So these are all the expected values from the previous part, part B, that I can plug in now. Okay, so now I need to find the chi-square test statistic, and I can go ahead and do this now. The degrees of freedom is always n minus 1, or the number of categories, so k minus 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means there are 5 degrees of freedom. So 6 minus 1. Okay, so let's go back to the calculator. Or you can use, again, any software you want, or you can certainly use the formula that they give you. But that's not right. This is a lot easier. So if you go to Stat and Edit, you see I already put those in. So L1, I put the observed. And then L2, I put the expected. Now, if you have something different, or if you plug them in differently, that's fine. But I just do L1 observed, L2 is expected. To go back to stat and then tests, and it's the very close to the very bottom. It's the chi-squared GOF test, which stands for goodness of fit test. And as you can see there, I do L1 for observed, L2 for expected. So if you have something different there, if you put observed in L3, let's say, you would just change that to L3. Degrees of freedom, remember, was 5. I already said that. And then calculate, and that gives us the chi-square value of 13.138, let's say. So 13.138. And that's that. Okay, the last part is we actually finish our test. So let's just look at this p-value. That's going to be the easiest route. So the p-value is 0.022. So let's go ahead and write that down. P-value is 0.022. And we're going to explicitly compare that to the alpha value. In this case, it's less than alpha. It's less than 0.05. So 0.02 is less than 0.05. Anytime the alpha value or the p-value is less than alpha, you reject H naught. Well, we didn't formally write down what the, H naught was, but it's understood in a goodness of fit test, the H naught is that these two distributions are the same. The observed and the expected are about the same, and we're rejecting that. So in this case, because we're saying it follows a Poisson CD, a Poisson distribution, we can say this data, I think it's bacteria, does not follow a Poisson distribution. Okay, because we're rejecting that, meaning we're accepting the alternative hypothesis, and the alternative hypothesis would be that this does not follow a Poisson distribution.